Hello children, I hope everyone are fit and fine. Stay home, stay safe. I would like to welcome you all for 5th standard science class through this video. Today in this session, I am going to teach you a new lesson in term 1 science book. My dear children, kindly have your term book in your hand. Topic of the lesson is organ system. Organ systems are group of organs that work together to perform one or more functions such as respiration, digestion, excretion, circulation, etc. From this lesson, you will be able to know about different organ systems of human body, identifying different organs, understanding the function of different organs. Okay, let me go to the lesson. We get energy for our daily activities from the food we eat. The food is broken down into simpler form. It is through the process called digestion. After we eat the food, waste products are removed from the body in the form of sweat and urine. The process involved in this is called excretion. We need oxygen to live. Our body gets oxygen through the process called respiration. These processes such as respiration, excretion and digestion are carried out by different organs in our body. Thus, different organs together form an organ system. In this lesson, let me study about different organ system in our body and their functions. First of all, let me see about digestive system. The food we eat consists of complex compounds like carbohydrates, proteins and fats. They have to be converted into simpler molecules like glucose, amino acids, fatty acids and glycerol respectively. This means carbohydrate is converted into glucose, proteins into amino acids and fats into fatty acid and glycerol. These simpler molecules such as glucose, amino acids, fatty acids and glycerol are then assimilated, that is absorbed by blood or lymph. Lymph is nothing but the liquid that is present in our body which transports useful substances around the body in order to give us energy. These simpler molecules are then absorbed by lymph or blood in order to give us energy. This process of conversion of complex food molecules such as carbohydrate, protein and fat into simpler molecules like glucose, amino acid, fatty acid and glycerol is called digestion. The digestive system can be divided into two types. The first type is digestive tract and the second type is digestive glands. The first type, digestive tract, is also known as alimentary canal. It is a coiled muscular tube extending from the mouth to the anus. It is about 6 to 9 meters long and consists of many specialized divisions. They are sequentially, that is orderly, arranged as mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. This means the food we eat enters through our mouth and then it passes through the buccal cavity and pharynx and then esophagus, then stomach, then small intestine, then large intestine and then finally at the anus. The second division of the digestive system is digestive glands. There are three important digestive glands associated with the process of digestion in human beings. They are salivary glands, pancreas, and liver. Salivary glands secrete saliva which moistens the food. That is, the saliva helps to grind the food easily. Saliva contains enzymes, that is chemicals, which break down complex molecules into simple molecules. Pancreas produces the enzymes, namely pancreatic juice, which contains digestive enzymes for digesting fats, proteins, and carbohydrates. Like that, liver produces bile for the digestion of fat. This is about the digestive system given in our book. The next organ system we are going to learn is respiratory system. The process of inhaling oxygen and exhaling carbon dioxide is known as respiration. The respiratory system provides oxygen to the tissues of the body and removes carbon dioxide from the tissues. Tissues are group of cells. There are three major parts forming the respiratory system. They are airway, lungs, and muscles of respiration. The type 1 airway. The airway includes the organs such as nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, and bronchioles. It carries air between the lungs and the surroundings. Thus, the airway includes the organ such as nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, and bronchioles. The second major part forming the respiratory system is the lungs. The lungs are the primary organs of the respiratory system. That is, the lungs are the important organs of the respiratory system. They are paired, that is, they are two in numbers and cone-shaped organs. They are located in the thoracic chamber, that is, rib cage, on both sides of the heart. The third major part forming the respiratory system is muscles of respiration. Muscles of respiration include diaphragm and intercostal muscles. They help to push the air in and out of the lungs during breathing. Thus, the respiratory system provides oxygen to the tissues of the body and removes carbon dioxide from the tissues. The three major parts forming the respiratory system are airway, lungs, and muscles of respiration. Airway includes the organs such as nostrils, nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, etc. Okay. So, the organs involved in the respiratory systems are nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, lungs, and muscles of respiration. The third organ system that we are going to see is circulatory system. In this system, blood is circulated to transport oxygen and nutrients to every part of the body. Circulatory system consists of the following, namely heart, blood vessels, and blood. Heart. The heart is a hollow muscular organ. That is, the heart is made up of muscles. It is somewhat conical in shape. The heart is covered with double-walled membrane called pericardium. That is, two layer of membrane. The two layer of membrane is called pericardium. The space between the membranes is filled with fluid called pericardial fluid. This pericardial fluid protects the heart from shock. Heart is placed inside the thoracic chamber in between the two lungs. The heart is divided into four chambers, that is, the heart is divided into four rooms. Two upper chambers are called atria or auricles. Two lower chambers are called ventricles. The upper and lower chambers of the heart are separated by a muscular wall or tissue known as the auriculoventricular septum of the heart. The right side of the heart receives deoxygenated blood from various parts of the body and pumps it to the lungs for oxygenation. That is, the right side of the heart gets deoxygenated blood, that is, the blood that doesn't contain oxygen from various parts of the body, and pumps it to the lungs for oxygenation, while the left side of the heart receives oxygenated blood from the lungs and pumps it to different parts of the body. The second organ that involves in the circulatory system is blood vessels. The blood vessels consist of arteries, veins, and capillaries. Arteries carry oxygenated blood while veins carry deoxygenated blood. Not all the arteries except pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood from the heart, while except pulmonary vein carries oxygenated blood to the heart. Capillaries are thin blood vessels which connect the arteries and veins. They help in exchange of materials between circulatory system and body tissue. The third organ that includes in the circulatory system is blood. The blood transports nutrients, oxygen, waste, and hormones. That is, the nutrients, oxygen, waste, and hormones are taken from one part of the body to other part of the body by blood. The volume of blood in human adult is 4 to 5 liters. It regulates water level and the body temperature. That is, the blood maintains water level and the body temperature. Blood is pumped throughout the body by the heart. It takes oxygen to tissues and cells and finally reaches the lungs to take oxygen again.